Hello, folks. How are we doing tonight? Well, I hope.
How are we doing tonight?
Oh, I'm talking to myself again. It's crazy when you talk to yourself. All right. I'm going to hurry tonight. I embark on a second leg of a radio tour tomorrow early in the morning. I've got two radio stops to do tomorrow. A meeting with Barry Rowland of Barry Rowland and Deliverance. Then I drive into North Carolina, up around Morganton, just between Asheville and Morganton, North Carolina. And the next morning I go to see John Wisnett, Jeff Wisnett's brother, at his radio station in Morganton. Then another radio station, and then Wednesday night, Lord willing, the Old Time Preachers Quartet will be in Durham, North Carolina at Liberty Baptist Church, singing for a camp meeting. Joe Arthur will be preaching, we will be singing, and we're looking forward to that. So if you're in the Durham, North Carolina area, won't you call the church and get the information there, Liberty Baptist Church in Durham, and be with us Wednesday night. Joe's going to preach the roof down, and we hope to sing the roof down if he doesn't preach the roof down. And if we both do it, then there will be no roof in sight. We'd love to have you show up and be there, okay? Patty says, heard I sang myself happy on the drive home, and it made the day a whole lot better. Well, Patty, I'm so glad you heard it, and I'm very glad that it made your day better. Thank you for that. Justin says, hey, brother, headed to Nashville in 2 weeks. Way to go, Justin. Right on, my brother. Nashville, just come on in and join us, would you? There's my aunt coming in late. Sue, you're late. You're slipping. Sherry Taylor, she's joining us there. I do some consultant work for her. I've been her producer for almost 20 years or something like that. But above all of that business, she's a friend to me and my family, and we're a friend to her. Good to have you, Sherry. Okay, I have got to, we're going to hurry on tonight because I've got to, I got to get ready for leaving early in the morning for this radio tour. Then I drive back, like a 10-hour drive Thursday, and then I meet with Donnie Williamson of the Williamsons early Friday morning. So this is a week of, whew, I don't know how many miles, and I don't know how many hours, morning, noon, and night. So I got to get ready. So here we go. Need you to call the radio show, like I always ask you to do, but you never do. And here I do all this work for you at night for nothing. You would think you would at least call my radio station. Now I'm scalding all of you. Scolding. All of you. I'm doing it with a velvet hammer, not with a jackhammer. But I sure would appreciate it if you'd call. And answer the following question. Who do you think will win favorite alto? I think Patty Graham. I think you called. Way to go. Way to go, Patty. Thank you for that. Favorite alto of the five nominees for this year's 2020 Singing News Fan Awards. Now, here you go. Will it be Sherry Easter of Jeff and Sherry Easter, Connie Hopper of the Hoppers, Courtney Metz of the Collingsworth family, Libby Stuffel of the Perrys, or Susan Wisnett of the Wisnetts? Call 800-360-5051, 800-360-5051, and tell me who you think will win. And I also want to note who you think they missed. Who do you think they missed? So favorite alto. All right. And if you haven't already, please vote. Please vote in the Scoops Diamond Awards. I've got a bunch of folks that I'm blessed to produce some work with that's up for a bunch of awards. The Williamsons are up for four awards, and they deserve all four of them. They're fantastic. Just go to Scoops Magazine. They're online. Just type in Scoops Magazine. It'll take you to their page. On the main page, it'll say you can vote for the awards. And please vote in those categories for my friends, if you would. The Williamsons, they're up for 4 different awards. Heaven's Mountain Band and the Bluegrass Gospel categories are up for 5 awards. And then Heart to Heart, they're up for 2. These are folks that I just signed a little while ago, and we produced a new record. And man, they're being played all across the country. XM, Enlighten, all the networks, everywhere. Their highest charting songs ever, award nominations. I'm so proud and happy for them. I really am. Good folks. And so vote for Heart to Heart in their 2 categories. And then I'm up in 2 categories. So, you know, if you think I deserve the Paul Heil Broadcasting Award, vote for me. If you don't think I don't deserve it, vote for somebody else. I get it. And I'm up for the J.D. Sumner Living Legend Award, which is given to old people like me. 42 years in the industry, and a bunch of folks nominated me, and I'm thankful for that and surprised. And again, vote for me if you think I deserve that. If somebody else is in the category, they deserve it more, vote for them. I'm pleased and just happy to be nominated. Okay, so we're going to go to, here it is, right here. We're still in the December 2010 Singing News magazine right there, which was the first issue that I published as publisher of the magazine. I'd been working for them over 10 years prior to that. But that's the first issue that I was on the top of the masthead as a publisher. And so we've been looking at this, and we're in the 2010 Singing News Fan Awards. Hey there, Scott. Hey, Jerry Edgel. Good to see you, sir. God bless you. Jerry Edgel, great DJ in Alabama, songwriter, singer, preacher, good man. God bless Jerry Edgel. Hello, Glenn. We'll look at the other folks, see who's with us here tonight, too. But so now we've stumbled on to the Singing News Fan Awards, and right there are the the winners in all the categories. So over the next few days, we're going to feature some of the songs from the winners. How about that? Now, I'm going to be on the road Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, but I'm going to do my best to bring music of the winners, and we're going to do Facebook Live on the road with Les Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Lord willing. Glenn Robinson says, Jerry Edgel is awesome. Jerry, did you hear that? He says you're awesome. And by the way, I agree with him. You are awesome. And then Jerry says, hey, brother. Hey, right back to you. Hey, Rabbit Easter. It's been a while since I've seen you, man. I hope you're okay. Are you all right? Miss seeing you, man. Okay, so here we are. And I'll show you some of the pictures as we go through this today. Matter of fact, let me go to this one picture right here. The very first thing we're going to do is we're going to feature that fellow right there when he was with the Triumphant Quartet. Triumphant Quartet. Jeff Stice right there. And I'm going to go back here to the first category. Favorite musician was Jeff Stice of the Triumphant Quartet. So what I'm going to do here is I am going to play. This is cool. Here's something really cool. Now, Triumphant Quartet, they started way after vinyl left and when CDs was here. Except, your old buddy Les has some vinyl autographed by all the guys. There's some of the memorabilia for today. So I'm going to this piece of vinyl. I'm going to play the Triumphant doing Saved by Grace, which was a huge hit, number one song. And Jeff did the production and playing the piano and the organ, and the intro was all him, and you'll see. So we're going to feature Jeff with the group Triumphant Quartet. And here we go. Let me get this started from the beginning. Let me try one more time here. Here we go. Saved by Grace. Vinyl from the Triumphant Quartet featuring Jeff Stice, the Musician of the Year, 2010 Singing News Fan Award.
Saved by Grace. I've been saved by grace. Away, saved by grace. swing open wide. Oh, I'm gonna sing redemption story of how he brought me from the other side. When I reach that city, the gates swing open wide. I'm gonna sing redemption story of how he brought me from the other side.
And yes, Jerry Edgel, sir, you are right. That was written by one Mr. Carol Magruder. Carol Magruder could write. And the Magruders had themselves a band. I'm just saying. Saved by grace. Grace, the unmerited favor of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know what? Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. And I'm telling you, one day, September of 1978, I looked into those same eyes and saw myself for who I was, a sinner, good for nothing, rotten, preacher's kid, trying to go to heaven on the shirt tails of a preaching daddy and a praying mama. I looked into those eyes of grace and I saw the sinner that I was and I saw the Savior that he is. And I, like Noah, found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Facebook Live with Les, Southern Gospel Music, Memorabilia Memories, and I just put some ministry on you right there. Thank God for the unmerited favor of the Lord Jesus Christ. Saved by grace. Jeff Stice, the Musician of the Year at the 2010 Singing News Fan Awards, which is what we are looking at today. And let's just see what else we got here. In the next category, it was Horizon Individual. And it happened to be that gal right there, Morgan Easter of Jeff and Sherry Easter. Right there she is, Morgan. She was the Horizon Individual Horizon Individual of the Year Award winner. So what say we listen to Morgan? Let's play a song that she was featured on early with Jeff and Sherry Easter. Matter of fact, this would have been right about, yeah, this was a song that was popular when she won the award, and she took the lead on it. It was a number one song. Now, it was a bishop song, but Jeff and Sherry redid it, and Morgan took the lead, and man, it is absolutely just fantastic. And we're going to let her sing it for you and show off her stuff. Why she was the Horizon Individual winner for 2010 at the Singing New Fan Awards. I need you more today.
There are decisions I can't make on my own.
Everything just the way your old buddy Les likes it.
Yeah,
that's real music right there, boys and girls. Not like some of this stuff from today. That was real music I just played for you with a real message. I need you more today than I did yesterday. And my Lord have mercy. Have you, unless you're under a rock, you have to know that that message is truer today than ever before. With what's going on in our world with coronavirus and burning down buildings and shooting at people. And man, we need the Lord today, right now, this very second. What a timely, timely message. And done well, Morgan Easter, the 2010 Horizon Individual Award winner at the Singing News Fan Awards. Good stuff. Let's see who's with us before we go into the next category here. Let's just see what we got going on. Patty Graham from Ohio. Justin Baker. Headed to Nashville in 2 weeks. Come on. Patty Graham heard I Sang Myself Happy. The number 4 song in the nation right now by the Old Time Preachers Quartet. Wow. Every time I say that, I hear myself say it and I go like, you're in a dream. When you wake up, you're going to see that it's not number 4. Sherry, hello, Justin, be glad to. How far are you from Nashville? If I'm in the studio that day, I'll be in Nashville. I work in Nashville studios all the time, but if I'm in my office, I've got 2 offices, both in Smyrna, but 2 different parts of Smyrna, which is just south of Nashville, about 20 miles. So there you go, Justin. That's where I am. My Aunt Sue's at Disney World in Orlando. What about that? That must be nice. Jim Rowland, good to see you. Bill and Patty, stop on by West Palm Beach and let's get a hot dog, he says. Wade Moser, hey, buddy. This is Brother Wade from Mountain Home, Arkansas. Good to hear from you, Brother Wade. Yes, sir. God bless you. I trust you're doing well these days. Brian Epinette, good to see you. Joe, there's Joe. There's Andy. Joe's telling me something here. What's this? Hey, did you receive a copy of our song? It's also on iTunes. God is in it too. Joe, I get about 50 to 75 songs a day, brother. I can't say that I did. If you'll send me an email as a reminder, I'll go on iTunes and check it out during my travels over the next 3 days doing this radio tour. Hello, John Morgan, Metzen Sr., Scott Agee, Jerry Edgel. We've talked about old Brother Jerry. Glenn Robinson likes Brother Jerry, too. There's Rabbit. Hey, Les. You've been busy. That's good, Rabbit. Man, I'm glad you've been busy, my friend. I trust all is well, and you are busy. That's good. Rebecca Ann Roberts is watching. Hey, Jerry, saying Carol Magruder wrote Saved by Grace. He sure did. Josh Harris, good to see you, sir. Paul Hyde, good to see you, Mr. Bass Singer. Danny Tuttle, Larry Nickel from East Tennessee, Tim Crouch. Boy, oh boy, what a musician. Tim Crouch, what a musician. Whew. Rebecca Rochester Matthews, good to see you, Rebecca, or Scott, or both of you, whomever may be watching here. My cousin Brenda Butler McGlone, good to see you, Brenda. Danny Albritton, good to see you, sir. Yeah. From Scott, good evening, Brother Les. Good evening, Brother Scott. Good to see you, brother. Been praying for your family and the corona that's hit some of your family there. Been praying for them. Just want you to know. Hello, Isaac from Middle Tennessee Baptist Church. Hello, Lee McNeil, you scoundrel, you. And there's old John Pope watching. All right, so let's go to the next song here. The next category in the 2010 Singing News Fan Awards was for favorite tenor, Michael Booth of the Booth Brothers. And I have something old here from the Booth Brothers. Let me get this in the big compact disc machine of love over here. And we will get, tell you what, we'll dial up Still Feeling Fine. He sings tenor on it, and then he goes into a tenor lead on it. So there's a whole bunch of Michael Booth, who in 2010 was the tenor of the year at the Singing News Fan Awards. So let's get this one going here. Let me see what we got. This is from a live album going back to, I think, like 2004, I believe. 2003. Going back a few years on the Booth Brothers. I'll show you some pictures here in a minute. You know this one? Sing along with me. Michael Booth winning the Tenor Singer of the Year in 2010 at the Singing News Fan Awards. And right there is a picture of him accepting that award right there. And yes, that is Dolly Parton over there to the side. She was part of the show that year, which the Fan Awards that year was done at Dollywood. And man, we had a big time. Here, I'll show you some of the other pictures. Here's Ed Hill being inducted into the Southern Gospel Music Hall of Fame, of course. He just went home to be with the Lord just a couple of weeks ago. So it's appropriate time there to show Ed When I get back from my radio tour, maybe next week we'll do an Ed Hill feature to celebrate his life. But there he is being inducted into the Southern Gospel Music Hall of Fame. And let's see, there's Bill Gaither talking to some fans. We'll show you Brother Bill right there, talking to a bunch of fans. And let's face it, he's got a bunch of fans. That is for sure. So there's a few pictures from 2010, the Singing News Fan Awards, as depicted in this pictorial here in the Singing News magazine, which again, I chose this one this time, just as a reminisce. That's the first issue that we published as myself as the publisher, Les Butler, publisher of the magazine. And so I've been with them over 10 years, but got that position and held that for several years. And it was a blessing, for sure. All right, so there you go. There's we've played the music, we've done the ministry, talked about grace a little bit. Thank God for the grace of God, the unmerited favor bestowed upon us. Just like Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord, I found grace in his eyes in September of 1978. What a wonderful thing, what a blessing. And he's still dispensing grace today. Unmerited favor, unmerited. You can't do anything to get it. You can't buy it. You can't call the president and have him give a presidential order for it. It's unmerited. You can't marry into it. It can't be your pedigree. Unmerited. Favor. Getting something we don't deserve. That's grace. Mercy is getting, not getting that which we do deserve. We deserve hell as sinners, but the grace of God. We don't deserve it. Unmerited favor. Thank God for his grace. Amen. All right, now I'm going to be on the road doing the old DJ tour for the next 3 days. Little stop Wednesday night in Durham, North Carolina, where the Old Time Preachers Quartet, we're going to do something that we never do anymore. Sing. Oh my, the cancellations have been unbelievable. But thank the Lord for Wednesday night, Brother Scott Gray, Liberty Baptist Church in Durham, North Carolina. It's going to be a big night. They're going to head out to the gym, and Joe Arthur will be preaching, great preacher, and they're expecting a big old crowd, but it's going to be all social distance. They've got everything 6 feet away, but it's big. It's a big place, and so there could be several folks there, and we pray that they are, and we pray that we stay 6 feet away and do all the right things, but still get together and worship the Lord. It's a wonderful thing to worship the Lord. Miss doing it in person with each other, don't you? I sure do. All right, well, that's it, and I'm going to take, Lord willing, I'm going to take some music on the road with me, and I am going to do my Facebook Live with Les from the road. And so Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you need to be watching 24/7. You can't go to bed. Don't go to bed or you'll miss something. Because I'm going to be on the road morning, noon, and night. And I'll do some Facebook Lives, bring some music with me, continue to feature the 2010 Singing News Fan Award winners. And we will have a great, great morning, noon, and night. We'll probably do several of them throughout the day. So just stay tuned, okay? Hey, pray for the family of Brother Sammy Allen, a great man of God, preacher who went home to be with the Lord yesterday, and pray for his wife, pray for his family, pray for the church. And Brother Sammy was, man, oh man, a prayer warrior unlike you've ever seen. And good man, just a God's man. But now he's at home with the Lord that he's preached about all of his life. And I'm happy for Brother Sammy. And we'll be with him one day. It's going to be good. Hey, Rabbit, I saw your note a while ago about, no, I'm not going to be in Oklahoma. You going to be there? If you're going to be there, I wish I could be there. We just jam. I hope you bring your steel if you're going to Oklahoma. And are they doing some kind of a big event? See who else here is with us. We've had a few people join us since we were last since I last said anything. There's Laura Ollis. Hello, Laura. Say hey to Eric for me. Tammy Sumner. Oh, Tammy works for me. Her dog drug her around the yard today, and she's sprained her ankle. Hope you're feeling better, Tammy. Big Bo, good to see you, sir. Hello, Joy. I talked to you earlier today. We're going to cook up some background vocals. Max Wilson from Mississippi. Max in the morning. Good to see you, sir. There's Rabbit. There's Sherry. Back on. I was honored to do a concert this past Saturday evening. Good crowd. That's good, Sherry. Man, I'm glad I'm hearing a few of those now. Not many, but a few. There's Christy Burrow. Hey, Les. Hey, Christy. Bama Bluegrass. Man, if you like bluegrass, look up Bama Blue-Grace. G-R-A-C-E. It's B-L-U hyphen blue as in bluegrass, not blue as in the color. Get it? Like B-L-U hyphen Grace. Bless the producer, last couple records. They've had some hit songs, number ones, and man, they're great. Honored to be associated with them, for sure. Okay. Be checking us out, man. And I'm going to try to bring you in behind the scenes at some of the radio stations where I'll be stopping, too. We did that last week. I had some fun. And so, no telling what's going to happen tomorrow, Wednesday, and Thursday, morning, noon, and night. Facebook Live with Les on the road. Christy says, which thief are you, Les? Well, you know which thief I am. I'm the one that said, remember me, Lord. I'm not the one that was scolding. I said scald twice tonight. Scolding the Lord. No. I'm one that said, remember me. What a great song. Which thief are you? That was number one in all the magazines, too, including the singing news. Tammy, hope you're okay. Prayers. Less prayers for your travels and the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, and amen, and amen. And thank you for all that joy. All right. God bless y'all. Be watching. Starting tomorrow.